Hello, this is Harriet Beecher Stowe, author of Uncle Tom's Cabin, or Life Among the Lonely. Because of the success of the two-volume first edition released on March 20th, 1852, which sold out after the first three printings in May 1852, and the 300,000 copies by the end of the year, I've decided to release the first illustrated edition in one volume this year, 1853. The first edition only had seven illustrations by Hammett Billings, and I asked him back, and he expanded the drawings to 117 for this deluxe edition. I am here in my home in Hartford, Connecticut, to talk to you about how the characters came about. Not to tell you the whole story of Uncle Tom's Cabin, that you will have to read for yourself, but to show you by way of Mr. Billings' illustrations, the story of the institution of slavery that it portrays. A mountain of research went into the characters that the writer used. By the way, I always use the third person to describe myself. That is the custom in the 19th century. The cast of characters were taken from real people as described in A Key to Uncle Tom's Cabin, and letters and stories of accounts of real slaves. The title hero, Uncle Tom, was inspired by the real story of former slave Josiah Hinson, who fled Kentucky and started a community of refugees in Ontario, Canada. Eliza Harris, who crossed the ice of the Ohio River barefoot, came from the account of an actual Eliza, who escaped the same way and was found warming herself in front of the fire in the home of abolitionist John and Jean Rankin in Ripley, Ohio. Other characters are a combination of people both northern and southern that I will point out as we go along. There is no bright side to slavery. Those scenes which are made bright by the generosity and kindness of masters and mistresses could be brighter still if the element of slavery were withdrawn. Slavery, therefore, is not the element which forms the picturesque and beautiful of Southern life. What is peculiar to slavery and distinguishes it from free servitude is evil, and only evil, and that continually. As I said in A Key to Uncle Tom's Cabin, my object has always been in writing to bring the subject of slavery as a moral and religious question before the minds of all those who profess to be the followers of Christianity in this country. There's one more person that I'd like you to meet. This is Eva, short for Evangeline or Evangelista. And she represents all that is good, beautiful, and loving in this world. She enjoys reading the gospel to everyone she comes into contact with.
Hi, I'm Eva. I taught Uncle Tom the Revelation in the Bible at the foot of the garden at St. Clair's Estate by Lake Ponchartrain. It was in chapter 22 that I read to him Revelation 15, verse 2, as I pointed to the lake.
Why don't you sit down and read that to us? Want me to take your doll?
And I saw something like a sea of glass mingled with fire, and those who have the victory over the beast, over his image, and over his mark, and over the number of his name, standing on the sea of glass, having harps of God. There it is.
Oh, there's the lake. Wow. Thank you, Eva. That was very nice. And would you like me to read to you? Mm-hmm. Here's your doll back. From my book, Uncle Tom's Cabin. So George here gave a short narration of the scene of Uncle Tom's death and of his loving farewell to all on the place and added, "It was on his grave, my friends, that I resolved before God that I would never own another slave while it was possible to free him, that nobody through me should ever run the risk of being parted from home and friends and dying on a lonely plantation as he did. So, when you rejoice in your freedom, think that you owe it to that good old soul, and pay it back in kindness to his wife and children. Think of your freedom every time you see Uncle Tom's cabin, and let it be a memorial to put you all in mind to follow in his steps and be as honest, faithful, and as Christian as he was. Did you like that?
Mm-hmm.
Well, thank you, Eva. I'm Harriet Beecher Stowe for Abolition News Network.
And I'm Eva.